Hey, this is Papa from StreetFighterTradingSystem.com. All right, so for this video, I'm back for frequently asked question. So the question of today is basically how can we know that a party can restart? Okay, because so actually someone on Discord who asked me this, like if we are in a super downtrend, how do we do to know that the party restart? Am I going to stop trading on all the downtrend or not? Okay, so first, for those who doesn't know what I'm talking about, please first look at the lesson number 6, too late to the party, common beginner's mistake, right? I'm gonna do a quick recap of that video. What I'm saying to you is basically when you have a trend, the idea is that you should take only the first two retrace. Okay, if you go, so this would be the first retrace, so impulse retrace, impulse retrace. So you can take only this one and this one. Past those, you cannot take any more trades on a downtrend, and it will be like the flip side on an uptrend. So down, up, down, up, down. Okay, so you can take only this and this. So before I explain you when can a party basically restart, I want to show you a little bit of theory on why do I tell you that you should take only the first two retrace, right? So one element, if you have looked at the video, is because I follow, I trade using Elliott Wave, but behind all the stuff that I'm showing you, actually there is probabilities. Okay, so I'm gonna do like a probability quick course on why I'm telling you that the first two are the ones that you should take. Okay, so for this, I'm gonna open Paint, which is my favorite tool. So basically, to explain what is happening, I'm gonna use two probability theory. So the first theory is called the Markov models, and the second one is the binomial tree, right? Of course, now you must say like, why the fuck Papa is talking about Markov model and binomial theory? But because everything, again, I repeat, that I showed you is based on probability, and I highly use a probability model to be able to construct what I'm showing you. Okay, so if we look at Markov, it says that Markov is a model, model is a stochastic model used to model randomly changing system. It is assumed that future state depend only on the current state, not only on events that occurred before it. Okay, bon. This is Chinese for most of the people, I guess. And second is the binomial tree is a graphical representation of possible intrinsic values that an option may take a different node or time period. Okay, so this may also sound Chinese for some people. So I'm gonna take the Chinese and translate it into English. So what it means, right, is let's say I start from a point zero. Okay, so we are at point zero on the market. And then I'm asking you, what is the probability that the market goes up and down or down? Okay, the probability is 50% that it can go up or the price can go down. Okay, so from this, I'm gonna draw. So let's say I'm gonna go to the upside. I'm gonna say, okay, if I go up, my chance is 50%. Okay, so zero will represent the state, my initial state. One will represent my state if I go higher, right? So that's why first it's called binomial, because I have two choices. So zero or one. Okay, so I have 50% chance that the price goes up, and I have 50% chance that the price goes down. Okay, so up, if I draw this, I have, so this would be like minus one, let's say. Okay, so 50%. Now, if I go on the node one, okay, now the same question. What is my probability, okay, that my price goes up or my price goes down? Okay, so the probability that my price goes up when I am on this node is not 50%, it's half 50%, meaning 25%. Okay, so here, if I want the price to go higher, I have half 50%, right? So it's 50% of 50%, which is 25%. Okay? And what is my probability that the price comes back to its initial state? But it's basically 75%. Okay? Because I can only have something that goes to 100%, right? So 25% plus 75 equals 100. So that's first the primary reason why you will hear a lot of people saying that 80% of the time, so you will hear that very often, okay? Some people will say that 80% of the time or 75% of the time for me, the market is actually in a range, okay? So the market is actually ranging because it's going up, then going down, going up, then going down, okay? In the same 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1. And that's why it's also important to understand some other techniques to be able to play in range. But this is another subject, okay? We are talking about how to play with the trend, okay? So the higher you go, so if I go on this node, right? So again, I have one. The more you're gonna go higher, right? But the lower is gonna be the probability that you're going to go up. So if you go need to go up here, so I apply the same thing here, it's half this half. So to go here, it's half 25%, which is 12.5%, okay? So the higher you go in time, the lower is your probability that the market is gonna go up, okay? So that's why when I'm saying that you shouldn't take trades after the secondary test, because after the second retrace, your probability of going higher is diminishing a lot, okay? But anyway, so this is behind the theory on why you should take only the first two retrace. Of course, as I said, I utilize a lot the Elliott Wave theory, and on Elliott Wave, it said that the market tends to work in basically three impulsive waves. So one, two, three. So something like this, right? So one, two, three. And often what they say is that the third wave can never be the shortest, right? So what you are banking on is either, so this one, you are taking the first retrace, which is the best one. The second retrace is not the best one, but it's still something that you can take a look at, right? So if you want to learn again about Elliott Wave theory, go into the internet. I'm not going to do a course about it. It's very, very long, right? So it will look like this, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, okay? And then I will have a retrace. Anyway, so now the frequently asked question was, when does the party restart? Okay, so let's say I have two waves to the downside. How can I know that I can start again at looking at the trades within the trend again? Okay, so for that, I have, I'm gonna show you what I use to basically know that a party restart, okay? So what I use is basically, I check that, so why is it not zooming? So I prepared some example and then after we'll go to the chart. So how I'm gonna know that a party restart is very simple. So what I'm gonna look at is first, let's say you have an uptrend, it has done like 50 wave to the upside. And then what I look at is basically if I have five waves that are going on the opposite way, but I, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then the price go below the 50 simple moving average. And then if the price cross back on the upper side, right, then I can look again for long opportunities. Okay, so I repeat, a party restarts if I'm able to count five waves on the opposite direction of the trend. So if it's going upward with the SMA, I can start looking back at up opportunities. Okay, so this was one example, the second one, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It goes below the SMA, so I can start back looking at long opportunities. Okay, on the short side, so I need to, let's say it was a huge downtrend like this. How can I know that the party restarts? I count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. The price goes above the 50 SMA. So I can look back at short opportunities, okay? Do I have another one? Yeah, this one. So the price did, so first retrace, second retrace. So you cannot take trade anymore. But since here it does 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, the price goes above the 50 SMA, right? So I can start back looking at opportunity to the downside. Okay, so this is the theory behind how can a party restart, right? Because if you are here, the party is locked, you cannot enter anymore. But if you are able to count five waves on the opposite direction, then a party restart, Okay. Another way of looking at it also is if you have your 50 SMA that is, let's say, flat during a certain amount of time, then it's okay to look back at a party. Okay. So let's take a look. Bon, my graph is pretty messy because I'm doing backtest, but don't look at it. So let's say here I had a huge downtrend. Okay, so my downtrend, I have my first impulsive move, first retrace, second retrace. Okay, so after this second retrace, I cannot take this short anymore, right? But what is happening? Am I going to stop trading now? So yes, until I see this. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, so if 5 wave on the upside, right? That goes above the 50 SMA, okay? So now I can start looking again at two-legged pullback or failed two-legged pullback if the price goes down, okay? So this is how basically you can understand that a party restart on the side in which you are trading, right? So again here, let's say it was going upward. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, okay? The price goes below the SMA and then here, whatever will go up, you can start looking back at opportunities, okay? So this is for the theory on how the party restarts. But now how do I use it in terms of setup, right? So what happens is usually when there is a party that restarts, I will try to find for failed two-legged pullback just after it, okay? So example again, you will see on all my charts, right? So on my example, I count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And here you see the next failed two-legged pullback that I will find, which is with the trend, okay? But I will take it, right? So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then I will do up, down, up. I will take a long trade over here, right? So this is one example. Here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, up, down, up. I will take the trade over here, okay? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, here, there is, so it does down, up, down. So down, up, down, up. So I could have placed a trade over here, okay? Again, up, down, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, up, down, up, down. So this, I wouldn't have taken it because it doesn't touch the EMA, right? So of course, I still apply the same rules that I apply normally to enter a trade, but most often when there is a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, okay, there is a high chance that it's gonna do a failed triggered pullback that is on the criteria that I follow. Okay, so let's take an example on the chart on yesterday, because yesterday I live traded with the guys on Discord, and then there is this opportunity that came up, right? So basically what happened is that we had a downtrend, so first impulse, so which is basically this impulse is a huge impulse, right? So this is sign of exhaustion. So I will usually not take trade over here, and in any case it didn't bounce on the EMA. So what I'm searching for to take short is to have a party that restarts. And it did, right? Because I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, okay? And then after the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, what am I hunting? I'm hunting to find, do I have a failed two-legged pullback or not, okay? Which is the case over here, right? I have a down, up, right? And then I will usually place a sell stop below this candle, okay? Which is bearish. And then I will take my 2 points reward, okay? So this is pretty much what I wanted to show you. Now, what you should do is try to exert yourself to look at parties first that goes down a lot, and then try to count 5 waves on the upside, right? And try to find failed target pullback within the party that restarts. Okay, you of course don't try to check it live, because on live you will never succeed. You need to train yourself to first look in the past. Okay, can you find it out? Me, I do use the 1000 tick chart. I repeat again, you can find it on the 2K tick chart. It is not a problem of chart or whatsoever. It's more a thing of looking at if you can find the setup offline, right? If you can find it offline, you will see that it will be easier for you to find it live, okay? So I think that was pretty much what I wanted to share. I hope it makes sense. You can ask question on the on the comment section of YouTube. Also, yeah, you see a lot of comments on my graph over here, so don't be scared. I'm starting to try to do a new strategy. So I'm just doing some market replays and then commenting a lot to see how I can get it to work. But anyway, the video of today was how you can know that a party restarts or not. All right, see you guys on the next video.